this was a Hollywood movie, I'd be walking away in slow motion from a foamy eruption. But it's not. But we still have to talk about gases. No, not that kind of gas. This kind of gas.
We are here at Eckerd College in St. Petersburg, Florida, to explore how gases are dissolved in liquids. This is very important for us here on the water, because the gases dissolved in our oceans play a number of roles in the world's ecosystems. In fact, marine wildlife depends on gases like oxygen in order to survive. And I survive on soda.
The amount of gas that can dissolve in a liquid is called solubility. And solubility depends on both temperature and pressure. Cold liquids are able to dissolve more gas than warm liquids. As for the pressure, we need to go ask Henry.
So Henry's law shows us that the solubility of gas in a liquid is related to the pressure of that gas above the liquid, as you can see here. So this means that more gas gets dissolved in the liquid as the pressure of the gas increases. To create fizzy sodas, carbon dioxide gas is dissolved into the liquid, and then it is sealed under even more CO2. This is to keep the gas soluble in the liquid. That's why they're packaged so tightly. The higher the pressure above the liquid, the more the gas stays dissolved in the liquid, meaning you get fizzier sodas. So when you open your cold soda and the pressure is released, the gas will escape out, as you can see here. So any remaining CO2 will then come into contact with any available surface, this leading to the bubbles that you see in your tasty drink.
Before we dive into things, we have to make sure we're equipped with the proper lab attire. First, safety goggles are a must to protect our eyes from any splashes. Second, gloves. It's a chem lab. Thirdly, I've got my pants and closed-toed shoes to protect from anything going down under. And lastly, I'm wearing my lab coat because it's cool and it keeps my clothes clean from any out-of-control soda eruptions. Now that we're safe and ready, let's take a look at the gases dissolved in our bubbly drinks. There is a lot more gas dissolved in these drinks than we realize. For this simple demonstration, we will use clear seltzer water, but any clear bubbly drink will work well. We will also be using a straw, a crafty pipe cleaner, a Mentos candy, and a clear cup, or in our case, a beaker.
As we carefully pour our cold seltzer into our beaker, we can see gas already being released as the liquid touches the surface of the cup. Now we can add our straw, and we can see that bubbles are already beginning to form on the surface of the straw. Surface area is the outermost layer of any object, sometimes called its texture. This texture determines how much contact an item can have with other objects, in our case, soda. However, straws are rather smooth, so let's increase the surface area so more bubbles can form. Our pipe cleaner is super fuzzy. This fuzz is due to chenille fibers. These fibers are chock full of surface area. Each of the thousands and thousands of fibers are different surfaces for bubbles to form onto. We can already see how much more gas is dissolved than we could with the straw.
Now, let's get a preview of what's to come and drop a Mentos candy in here. Although Mentos looks shiny and smooth, there is actually a lot of surface area. This is due to millions and millions of teeny tiny pockets, ridges, and dents that are all on its surface. That's a lot of bubbles. Are you ready to see how much gas is dissolved in a bottle of soda? We have to step outside for these bubbles. It's that much gas. Okay, this is a much better setting for big amounts of bubbles. For this part of the experiment, we are going to need Diet Cola, a tube of Mentos, some pebbles, and some sand. Where are we gonna get sand? Oh, be right back. Okay, I've got my sand, and while I was out there, I grabbed these. These nifty little tubes are made out of construction paper, and they fit on top of the soda, and they will hold equal amounts of volume of the Mentos, the pebbles, and the sand. Let's do the Mentos first. We're going to use this index card to hold the Mentos in the tube until we get it over the position of the bottle. And now, I'm going to remove the index card and try to get out of the way. That was awesome! The carbon dioxide molecules dissolved in the soda attached to the surface of the Mentos, just like they did in the seltzer water, but on a much larger scale. All those Mentos and a lot of soda make for a lot of bubbles, and those bubbles rise to the surface and shoot out like a geyser through this small opening. Let's do that again, this time with the pebbles.
As we just saw, the pebbles barely had any eruption compared to the sand in the Mentos. This is because there's hardly any surface area for the bubbles to form onto. That's because our pebbles are made from a nice smooth glass, which limits the amount of surface area on our pebbles.
And now this time with the sand. This is a very easy demonstration to do at home. Diet Cola is recommended, since there is no sugar and we can avoid the sugary sticky mess. Though, any carbonated beverage will do. Try it for yourself in an outdoor area, and wash away all that foam with fresh water from a hose or a bucket. You can also make the experiment your own by doing the same weight instead of the same volume. You can do this by using a kitchen scale to measure out your materials. You can also use the same kind of tubes, however, they will not go up to the same point. Aside from making pretty awesome messes, there's a lot we can learn from this. First, we learned that different amount of surface area can cause gases to come out of a solution. A smooth straw can only collect a few amount of bubbles, but a handful of sand with much more surface area per grain can collect so many bubbles in a bottle that it causes a huge eruption. It is very important that we understand how gases are dissolved in liquids, especially water. As I stated earlier, fish, sharks, and other marine wildlife depend on oxygen dissolved in the oceans to survive. Our own respiration relies on oxygen and carbon dioxide to be dissolved in our blood to be transported from cell to cell. However, not all dissolved gases are good. There is so much carbon dioxide in our atmosphere that our oceans are dissolving more carbon dioxide. This leads to ocean acidification. These acidic oceans lead to coral bleaching and can prevent marine animals from developing their hard shells. So remember, dissolved gases can be an environmental issue, a lifeline, delicious, or just so much fun.